Welcome back, data scientists. Today we're going to fine-tune a large language model on our very own documentation to create a domain expert AI assistant. So what exactly is fine-tuning? Well, it's the process of customizing a pre-trained model to suit your specific needs. Naturally, there are a few ways to do this. In this tutorial, we'll be focusing on parameter-efficient fine-tuning, or PEFT, using Low Rank Adaptation, or LoRA. Basically, we're going to retrain an open source LLM on UbiOps documentation to make it better at answering questions about UbiOps. And since we're doing it with LoRA, the process will be faster, cheaper, and less resource intensive. Another commonly used technique for adapting pre-trained models is retrieval augmented generation, or RAG. Rather than adjusting a model's behavior like fine-tuning does, RAG provides additional context to guide a model's response. RAG won't get you the same level of domain knowledge as fine-tuning, but it's easier to implement and suits most use cases. We have a separate tutorial video for RAG, so feel free to go and check that out. So in this tutorial, you'll be creating a chatbot fine-tuned on custom documentation using the Mistral 7B instruct model from HuggingFace. You'll start by prepping your data, then you'll set up a training run to fine-tune your model. You're going to need to create a couple experiments and training runs in this tutorial. So if you don't know your way around model training and UbiOps, check out our model training playlist to get up to speed. First things first, setting up your accounts and environments. You'll need access to the UbiOps platform and the Mistral 7B model from HuggingFace. So go ahead and create your accounts and get access to the model. Once you have your accounts set up, it's time to get your training data ready. You'll be using technical documentation from UbiOps as your dataset. The documentation needs to be pre-processed by tokenizing it and splitting it into chunks so that your instance's virtual RAM doesn't run out. The easiest way to do this is by grabbing the pre-processing code from our written tutorial and creating a training run in UbiOps to run it. After this step, your data is ready for fine-tuning. With your data pre-processed and ready, it's time to fine-tune your model. You'll use techniques like quantization to optimize your model's use of resources and speed up your fine-tuning process. The code to include in your training file can be found in the full written tutorial, and here's what it's basically doing. Defining quantization and LoRA configurations, loading the model, and defining the number of epochs and the batch size. Once that's done running, you fine-tune your model. Now you can put it to the test by calling the chatbot and asking it a question. We asked it, how could Harry Potter use UbiOps to defeat Voldemort? Here's the response. Harry Potter could use UbiOps to build a predictive model to anticipate Voldemort's next move based on historical data. He could also use UbiOps to automate the deployment of spells or potions, allowing him to focus on strategic planning. Additionally, UbiOps could help Harry and his friends analyze large amounts of data from various sources, such as the Ministry of Magic or Hogwarts Library, to gain insights and make informed decisions. And there you have it. With just a few steps, you can fine-tune your model and create a customized chatbot tailored to your use case. Thanks for joining me and following along. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more tech tutorials and insights. See you next time.